changing what I meant. How fragmented we've become through time. Family pictures are the only one reminders of better moments to come. Perhaps a song or two for bonus fun memory. Albeit turmoil and storm will inspire us to retreat from employment or season of enjoyment. The spoils of heritage, voices of cheer and sorrow, hymns to be sung, and there's so much work to be done. Traditional torment for the choices of a soul, and letting a loved one go. Mourning turns to temporary insanity, so separation, anxiety, and or adornment for a person doesn't seem so logical. For example, you've had ample opportunity to call on your uncle and auntie to say hello, but then sometimes we get tied up and become neglectful. I too suffer from this malady of time managing and check balancing when there's more to reality and being respectful. Being respectful. Being respectful. It seems all the photographs, etc., as well as laughs, togetherness of the past has polarized. What can the younger ones see through the older eyes? Forever is only a mile away down the road in the sky, chasing dreams in the wind as leaves and seeds in summer sun. We are still connected by some nurturing element, such as the air we breathe. We still don't fall far from the tree, rooted settlement of all under one. In a way we're rearranging our DNA, structured by humbleness as gentlemen and ladies in a public place. Prenuptial relations just in case we're changing faces. Que sera, sera, the so-called phrases. Yay, hurrah, hurrah. You know this all day. To keep integrity, don't sleep in brevity. It's very deep. We compromise our longevity. We sacrifice equity and run away. Stay determined to keep the tribe alive, even if it's in your pride. You've had bigger fish to fry, and when there's love and judgment, maybe you'll get your own wish goodbye. But until then, stay strong, my friend, and be respectful. Be respectful. Be respectful. Being respectful.